CW23 presents See What's Now, your entertainment news source.
Hey everybody, it's John and Katie with CW23, and today we are very excited to have Maury Povich from The Maury Show, which airs every weekday at 4 p.m. right here on CW23. Maury, thanks for being with us.
John, Katie, nice to be with you. John, how's fatherhood?
Fatherhood is going great, and like I was going to say, last time we had you on, we did a paternity test. Things didn't go great because first you said that I wasn't the father, then you said you had the wrong envelope, and I am the father.
Yeah.
I actually have another one on the way, and I think because
You're kidding.
Of the way it went down last time. No, I'm not kidding. I think we're going to pass the paternity test this time.
Really? Well, not so fast.
Well, I had a heart attack last time, so...
Well, Maury, May 25th marks your 3,000th episode. And in the meantime, you're going to be airing a lot of highlights leading up to it and some of your most memorable moments on the show.
Right.
What do people have to look forward to?
Well, I mean, what we've done is kind of culled all the episodes in 18 years, and we found the most dramatic, the wildest, the most outrageous. And so we're going to air them once a day, leading up to the 3,000th show, when you're going to get a compilation of everything. And probably the most memorable lie detector test show we've had is when a fellow was being accused by his girlfriend of cheating on her. And on three different occasions, he was missing for 3 days at a time. And he claimed that he wasn't cheating, that he had been kidnapped
wow.
and put into the trunk of a car for 3 days.
Wow, that's commitment to a story.
On three different occasions. Well, and I broke up. I could barely get through the episode. And you'll see it. It's going to be airing during those 30 days.
Very nice. You may have just answered my next question, because my next question was, what is your favorite moment?
Well, I'd say the favorite moment in terms of the paternity test was when a woman was accusing a fellow of being the father of her twins, and when I opened up the envelope, because I don't know the answers, I opened it up, and he was the father of one, but not the other.
Wow.
That,
uh-oh.
And I looked around, and my staff told me, with fraternal twins. So, John, if you're gonna have twins.
I'm getting nervous here. I think I might have to get a drink or something.
And Maury, your wife is also getting involved in all of the fun. Tell us about that.
When Connie Chung gets a microphone in her hand, you never know what's going to happen. I really don't know what kind of clips they're going to run with Connie, but you know, with Connie Chung, you always expect the unexpected.
Very cool. And tell us about this 360 virtual reality.
Yeah, you're moving on up in the technology.
Yeah, how about that? I mean, you talk about new media. You now, if you go on Facebook, you can watch a segment of the show in 360 degrees from any angle you want, from the audience, from the back of my head. You can see all the gray hair back there, and you can it just is a new look, kind of a new media look to my show.
We were checking it out yesterday, and I think Katie's comment was, I'm in Maury's lap right now.
I felt like I was sitting in the chair or just right in front of you.
Wow, you too could be a guest, Katie.
Yep.
Oh, I hope not.
And you guys are very up to date with the times, very relevant right now, because I saw this Ted Cruz meme going around the internet.
Yes.
What's up with that?
We had a woman on named Cersei, you know, and there was a particular angle of Cersei, and they matched it with Ted Cruz, and you would have thought that they were twins. I mean, it was just unbelievable, and it went viral.
Did you notice it before it went viral?
No, like, not
did
at
you
all.
See the resemblance?
Not at all.
Okay. So you, it's baseball season. The Twins not doing so well right now.
Yeah.
Hopefully they can turn it around. But one interesting fact we saw is that you were actually a bat boy back in the day. Is that true?
I was a bat boy for when the Twins were the Washington Senators. And more interesting than that is that the Twins' first year in Minnesota in 1961, I was an assistant to the broadcaster, a fellow named Bob Wolf, who'd come to Washington for that summer, and Halsey Hall and Ray Scott. And
wow.
I was there at Old Metropolitan Stadium doing the 1961 inaugural season of the Minnesota Twins.
Very cool.
Well, maybe you can come join us out here this season. We'd love to have you. Everyone, make sure you tune in to The Maury Show, 4 p.m. on weekdays on CW23.
Right, and I hear you have a great stadium.
We do have a great stadium.
Do.
Come by, check it out.
Terrific.
We'll get you a jersey.
Thank you.
Bat boy.
All right. Thanks for talking to us, Maury.
Thanks.
Okay.